Do you want to learn how to customize foundation models to transform them into your business experts? By using continued pre-training and fine-tuning, you can do exactly that. Let me show you how. Hello, I'm Seb. Welcome to this first part of this three-part mini-series of video. In video two, you will learn about retrieval augmented generation, RAG. And in the third video, you will learn about conversational agent. For those of you who worked with foundation models or large language models, as we call them, from the one from the most popular companies in this domain, like Anthropic, Meta, Mistral, or OpenAI, you quickly realize that these models are able to handle a whole variety of tasks, and they do it really well as long as we stay within the model comfort zone. As soon as we're trying to ask questions to the models on subject it has not been trained for, the quality of the result decreases dramatically. In this first video, let's see how we can extend a model comfort zone. Here's Paul. He's my new business assistant. He's the best in his class and entire generation. Paul has been trained on everything that can be read on the internet. He has an immense memory of 80 billion tokens. He's very good at writing, summarizing, or classifying text, but he doesn't know a clue about my business. And I want Paul to help my customer to answer questions about our product. So how can I ensure Paul is knowledgeable about my private IP? I'll show you two techniques to increase Paul's comfort zone: continue pre-training and fine-tuning. The first option is to send Paul back to school and let him continue to learn on a large volume of additional data. I agree with you, the word pre-training here is a bit confusing. Pre-training is the task of training a foundation model before any kind of specialization. And this is what the large language model providers such as Meta, OpenAI, Anthropic do. So it produces a general purpose model, hence the usage of the term pre-training. But the idea is to expand the model's comfort zone for better performance on the specific task to carry out. Continue pre-training excels at adding more information to a model, new vocabulary and acronyms, for example. It's about adjusting an existing pre-trained model on a new specific dataset consisting of plain textual data. This technique is helpful for infusing domain-specific information like linguistic patterns, like domain-specific language, acronym, or information implicitly contained in raw full text into the model parametric knowledge to align the model response to fit this specific language or knowledge domain. Continued pre-training to inject new vocabulary and acronyms to the foundation model and produce new foundation model, a new foundation model that you need to evaluate and to deploy. You use large quantities of unstructured data. And the larger is the foundation model you use as a starting point, the largest is the quantity of data you must use to weight in the new large language model. It's a bit like warming up water by adding hot water in a bucket of cold water. The more cold water there is in your bucket at start, the more warm water you must add to elevate the water temperature in the bucket. I'm not going to do a demo of this because it requires a large data set that I don't have, and the pre-training can take hours or days to complete depending on the size of the original model and the quantity of the data at hand. Okay, that was the first option for Paul. Continue his learning, send Paul back to university, but this time with data specific to my domain. The second option is to send Paul to a specific training. Imagine I want him to be able to help support agent to answer customer calls. I can send Paul to a training in a call center where he will sit down and listen and remember all conversation for a period of time. The goal here is not to learn new things, but get used how support agents respond to calls and how they talk with customers. He can also gain a bit of domain-specific knowledge during the process. So fine-tuning leverage transfer learning to efficiently inject niche expertise into a foundation model. The process involves updating the model weights through training on domain-specific data while keeping the overall network architecture unchanged. Unlike a full pre-training, which requires a massive data set and compute power, fine-tuning is highly sample and compute efficient. You can fine-tune a model with as little as hundreds of data. Fine-tuning isn't meant to add new information to your model. It's meant to change how your model behaves. Typical use cases for fine-tuning include ensuring the model responds in a specific way, with a specific tone, or learning to generate complex outputs, like in tasks that currently require a chain of prompts. As an additional benefit, fine-tuning might reduce the number of tokens you need or the latency for the request you send to the model. The main difference between continued pre-training and fine-tuning is that fine-tuning requires annotated data. This means that the data must be in a very specific format, like question and answer. You can write scripts or use foundation model to generate such data from raw data that you have. Let me show you fine-tuning with Amazon Bedrock. I go to the Amazon Bedrock console and I select a data set. So for this example, I went to Kaggle and I download a structured data set coming from NVIDIA. It consists of more than 6,000 questions and answers about NVIDIA products. In the Bedrock console, I select Customize Model, create a new customization. I can then enter the parameter for my dataset, like the S3 bucket, the input bucket. I can also use a subset of the data to validate my customization, and I give an output bucket for the validation data. Then I train the model, and after a few hours, I can deploy that model with the provision throughput method. So I select which of my customized model I want to deploy, and how much quantity of CPU and memory I want to deploy in provision throughput. These two parameters will influence the price of the deployment of the model. So let's take an example. I ask a model without any fine-tuning what is a hybridizer. And the model answers me, an hybridizer is a person who develops new cultivars of asexually reproducing plants such as hybrid roses. Probably a good answer, but it's not related to NVIDIA. So if I ask the same question again to the fine-tuned model, the response I receive is totally different. It answers exactly the question it received in the training dataset. An hybridizer is a compiler from Altimesh that enables programming GPU and accelerators using C# code or .NET assembly. And that's the end of this demo. I explain how you can increase a foundation model comfort zone by using either continued pre-training on a large amount of unstructured data or to fine-tune the model by providing it with a medium to a large set of structured data. Using one of these two techniques, Paul is now my new business expert. There are two other techniques to transform Paul into a business expert without teaching him anything new, but just leveraging what he can do well today. But that's the subject of another video. I hope this video was useful. Please share it with your friends and give us some feedback. And now, go build.